Okay, hi everybody. In the previous session, we have discussed about the principle of working of determination of E by M of electron by Thomson's method. As we have seen, the basic principle behind this experiment is subjecting a beam of electrons to electric and magnetic field and analyzing their path. So, we wanted to see what is the effect of electric and magnetic field on electrons. So, we have been discussing that. First, we have discussed the effect of electric field on the moving electrons. So, these electrons will experience a force when they are subjected to an electric field. And the force experienced is given by F is equal to E into E. And small e is the charge of the electron, capital E is the strength of the electric field. So, force experienced is in the direction of the field in the case of a positive charge, and it is opposite in the case of a negative charge. We have also discussing about the effect of magnetic field on a moving charge, and is given by F is equal to E into V cross B, or V cross B is VB sin theta n cap. So, that is the expression, and we have also seen that this force will be maximum whenever the angle between the velocity and the magnetic field is 90 degree, or the velocity and magnetic field are at right angles to each other, the force experience will be maximum and is given by Fleming's left hand rule. In this case, if velocity and magnetic field are in xy plane, the force experienced will be perpendicular to this, that is along the z plane. So, that's about the principle, and this is the experimental setup, a CRT tube or gas discharge tube. And we were discussing about the description of the apparatus. So, the apparatus mainly consists of a gas discharge tube or a CRT, wherein we have got two electrodes, C cathode, A anode. A high potential difference is maintained between them, and there is an arrangement of two metal diaphragms which are connected to the anode, so that we can get a collimated beam of electrons. The electrons which originate from the cathode, they move in a straight line and reach the screen S, that is the fluorescent screen inside on that gas discharge tube. And there are two metal plates between which an electric field is applied, and a magnetic field is also applied in a perpendicular direction. This is the experimental arrangement, and the procedure goes like this. The apparatus consists of a discharge tube as shown in the figure. C is the cathode, A is the anode. A potential difference is applied between anode and cathode. Electrons are originated, and these electrons pass through the metal diaphragms D1 and D2. Maintained at an anode potential. This fine beam of electrons is allowed to fall on the surface of the discharge tube, which is of course coated with fluorescent material like zinc sulfide, barium, platino cyanide, and the spot S is formed. This is in the absence of electric and magnetic field. Now, P and Q are two metal plates between which a suitable potential difference is applied. That is, we are now applying an electric field to the beam of electrons. So, electrons are allowed to pass through an electric field, or electrons are subjected to an electric field now. Due to this electric field, the electronic beam is deflected upwards, and now the fluorescent spot is obtained at S1. Now, it is the turn of the magnetic field. Now, electron beam is subjected to a magnetic field by applying this magnetic field in a plane perpendicular to the plane of the paper here. Say North Pole is in front of the paper and South Pole on the other side, so that magnetic field is into the paper or plane of the board away from us. So this is the direction. So in this situation, the velocity is along x direction, the electric field is negative y direction, and magnetic field is in the z direction. So velocity, magnetic field and electric field are mutually perpendicular to each other. So here the dotted region in the diagram represents the region of the magnetic field. The direction of the electrons is downwards. The fluorescent spot is now formed at S2. So to summarize, in the absence of electric and magnetic field, the spot is formed at S. There is no deflection to the electron beam. In the presence of electric field, when an electric field is applied, the electron beam is deflected upwards, the spot is formed at S1 in the upward direction. When the magnetic field alone is applied, once again because of this magnetic force, the electron beam is deflected downwards and a spot is formed at S2. These are the three different cases in the case of subjecting the beam of electrons to electric and magnetic field. Now let us discuss about the theory of this experiment. At first, the electric and magnetic fields are removed, as we have discussed already. The spot is formed at S. Now the magnetic field alone is applied. And what is the effect? Let us go for certain notations. The magnetic field is B, electronic charge is E, the velocity of the electrons V. So the magnetic force experienced is given by Lorentz force, B into E into V, or BEV. The direction of this force, as we have discussed, as given by Fleming's left hand rule, is perpendicular to the plane containing the velocity and magnetic field. Now, because of this, instead of moving straight, you can see in this diagram, say in the absence of electric or magnetic field, the electrons would move along KS. This is the straight line path in the absence of the field. When a magnetic field is applied, the electrons are subjected to a circular path. They will move in an arc of a circle like this. They will not move like this. Because of this force, they are subjected to move in an arc of a circle, and they reach the point B, that is in the region of this dotted area. This is because of Lorentz force or magnetic force. Once it comes to the point B, then it continues in this tangential direction B dash S2. So in the presence of magnetic field, the trajectory of the electrons would be from K to B dash in the form of an arc of a circle like this, arc of a circle. From B, it straight away goes to S2. So this is the effect of magnetic field on the electrons. So we'll continue our discussion in the next session.